Cosmetics include skin creams, lotions, powder, sprays, fragrances, makeup, manicure products, makeup other than eye stuff, hair coloring preparation, shampoos, permanent waves, other hair products, tanning things. These are all cosmetics. Doctors are usually not doing those. Cosmeceuticals. I'm sure somebody in here is going to take exception to this. I copied this off the FDA. Cosmeceuticals, this is from the FDA, the FD&C Act does not recognize any such category as a cosmeceutical. Product can be a drug, a cosmetic, a combination of both, but the term cosmeceutical has no meaning under law. It is a marketing term that was coined by this industry, and I hope you don't get sucked into. I'm a paramedical esthetician, and I do cosmeceuticals because none of those really exist. Paramedics exist, but they work on ambulances, and you have to have training and licensing for that. You don't get to do paramedic stuff unless you are a paramedic. It says, while the Food and Drug Act doesn't recognize the term cosmeceutical, cosmetic industry has begun to use the word to refer to cosmetic products that have drug-like benefits. And because the industry has been taking this to such an extreme, the FDA has now started making lists of companies that they've sent cease and desist letters to for making claims that fall into drugs. FDA defines drugs as products that cure, treat, mitigate, or prevent disease, or that affect the structure or function of the body. So if anything you're doing says that it will affect or change the skin or change the body or make you sleep better or help you quit smoking or lighten your skin or anti-aging that's going to remove wrinkles, those have to be drugs. And they have to be on, they will be on the FDA's website as a drug. So cosmetics don't do that. Cosmetic Ingredient Review Panel, which is the CIR that I have up there, it's a division of the FDA, and they have panels on different types of things. The Cosmetic Ingredient Review Panel is a series, it's a bunch of chemists, and they get together on any one ingredient or chemical that goes into products for cosmetics, and they decide whether it is or isn't a cosmetic item. And sometimes they ask for testing, and sometimes they ask for studies, 3, 5, 10-year studies. When they do, the industry has to pay for those. And then they have to bring the results back, and then the Cosmetic Ingredient Review Panel decides whether it is or is not allowed as an ingredient in a cosmetic product. They're the ones that came up with the alpha-hydroxyglycolic acids. Cosmetic concentrations do not exceed 30% and do not have a pH lower than 3. So if you have a 45%, 1.6, this is a medical product. If you have a 20 concentration with a pH of 2, it's a medical product. So you need to look at both. And some of the inspectors in some of the states are actually looking at the bottles to see what it says on it and what the concentration is. So it's and, not or. Salicylic acid, Jesner peels, all of these things are, these are cosmetic in most states. Now, there is a state that does not allow Jesner peels, but that, nobody here from Ohio? You're from Ohio? Don't do Jesner peels there. It's a bad idea. But you have a really good website. Ohio has a great website, and your inspectors will tell you whether a device or a chemical or whatever is allowed because they're kind of right in tune with the FDA. So you've got it pretty easy. Microdermabrasion can be done. Loofah and sponges, you can use those. Please be careful. With the exclusions of the carbolic acid, which is phenol, these are going to, anything down here, I don't know how to say that, trichloroacetic, is that right? TCA. Those would be adulterated chemicals in a cosmetic because those technically fall under medical.